Sergeant Moo is guarding the door. We're going to go ahead and talk to Sergeant Moo real quick.
Sergeant Moo?
Ah, Monsieur Stobart, n'est-ce pas?
That's correct. You remember me.
The retention of such data is part of my duty as a gendarme. That is our crime is fought, through attention to detail, not intuition.
Yes, sure. I was one of the last people to see the victim alive, Sergeant.
Does that worry you?
Yes, it does. I feel I owe it to him to find his killer.
That is best left to the authorities, monsieur. Did he speak to you? Tell you anything?
No. He just grinned and nodded.
Don't let it trouble you, monsieur. Go home and try to forget.
What is Rosso doing with that girl?
He is giving her the once-over, as you Americans say. Once he gets his teeth into a case, nothing will shake him off.
Look, Sergeant, the inspector gave me his card.
Yes, monsieur. He wants you to advise him if you have any information concerning this case.
Well, I'd be glad to talk with him, but I don't want him working his psycho weirdness on me.
Ah, no, monsieur. You are confusing the science of parapsychology with witchcraft.
Oh, yeah? What's the difference?
We don't do sacrifices.
Fair enough.
See you later, right. Sergeant.
Nico's here. Let's talk to her.
Excuse me, mademoiselle?
Hi. My name's George Stobart.
Oh, an American by the sound of it.
Yep, that's right. On vacation in Paris.
Some vacation, huh?
You were here when the bomb went off?
Sure was. Sat right out in front of the cafe.
Did you notice a middle-aged man, maybe 60, with a hat and overcoat?
I couldn't believe it. She hadn't even asked how I was feeling.
Yeah, he went inside just before the bomb exploded.
You weren't related to him, were you?
Oh, no, nothing like that. I'm Nico Collard, from La Liberté.
What is that, some kind of nightclub?
Oh, no, it's a newspaper.
You're a reporter?
I'm a freelance photojournalist.
Say, you could interview me about the bombing. An eyewitness account, minutes after the outrage that shook the whole of Paris. You know, real-life drama, human interest, that kind of stuff.
I'll just stick to the facts, thank you. Did you see who planted the bomb?
I know it sounds crazy, but he was dressed like a clown.
A clown? It's him again.
Who was the guy you were supposed to meet?
His name was Plento. I didn't know him, but he called me last night. He said he had a story which would interest me. He asked me to meet him at the cafe. I guess I'll never know what he wanted to tell me.
Well, not unless you have Rosso's gift for psychic interrogation. How did Plantard get your name?
Through the newspaper, La Liberté. I'd written an article linking two unsolved murders, one in Italy, the other in Japan. The cases were remarkably similar. A wealthy victim, no apparent motive, and a costume killer. Plantard said he could supply me with more information. Somehow the clown must have known about our appointment.
Do you know a police officer called Rosso?
Rosso? Our paths have a knack of crossing. If I didn't know better, I'd say it was deliberate. Have you seen Rosso? Is he here?
He's inside, attempting to question a witness with his psychic powers.
That guy is weird.
Yeah. Have you met the clown before?
It's a long story.
I have plenty of time.
I don't.
Why won't you tell me about the clown?
Why do you want to get involved?
Because he almost killed me. Isn't that reason enough?
I guess so. Listen, I'll give you my phone number. You help me with my story, and I'll let you in on what I know. And let's get one thing straight right now. This is strictly business.
Okay, it's a deal.
I have to go develop these pictures. I'll be on phone with you.
Fine. I'll see you soon.
Basically go where we were going to go before, before the sergeant stopped us. Talk to this fellow.
Hey, you!
I thought you'd been arrested!
Nah, it was a misunderstanding.
When he pulled that gun, gah! I thought that was it. Those automatics packed quite a punch, you know?
He made a mistake. He thought I was a terrorist.
You? A terrorist? Ha!
He was only doing his duty, I guess. Did you see an old guy with a briefcase?
Wait, silly old coot. Do you know what he said to me? Work fascinates me, he says. I could watch it all day. Care beat. I could have knocked his block off.
Did you recognize the old man?
No. Should I have done? Was he a celebrity?
No, but I guess he is now. His name was Plantar.
Was? He's dead then?
Yeah.
That's too bad. Now I wish I hadn't called him what I did. If only I could turn back the clock. If only I'd been more tolerant.
Regret and remorse are strange emotions. They really bring out the hammiest actors in people.
Did you see a clown come by this way?
A clown? Like, in a circus?
Yeah, with makeup and a big red nose.
Huh! Those guys are funny, aren't they?
Not in my experience.
I love the circus, especially the horses.
You haven't answered my question. Have you seen a clown?
You think I've got time to watch everyone who passes by? Some of us have to work for a living.
Look, I know you're busy, but surely you'd have noticed a clown.
I told you already. I didn't see a thing.
He was wearing multicolored baggy trousers and makeup.
He'd be a poor sort of clown if he didn't.
Listen, I have to find that clown. He's a killer.
Say, who are you anyhow? A cop?
No, of course not. I mean, do I look like a cop?
No, but you act like one, sticking your nose in where it's not wanted. How do you know this guy's a killer? Did you see him in action?
Didn't you hear the explosion? The cafe was blown up.
I wondered what that bang was. Any bodies?
Yeah, an old man was killed.
Merde. I didn't think it was that serious. What about the waitress?
Oh, she's fine.
Thank the saints.
I gotta go.
Don't let me keep you.
We need to find something to get him away from there, because we need to check his toolbox to see if there's anything we can use to pry open that manhole that we saw earlier. And what's this?
Salah-ed-Din. I noticed the writing at the foot of the page. It read, Salah ed-Din, 1345.
If I'm not mistaken, Salah ed-Din is a horse. And
the big story was about the brutal murder of a French
media magnate.
Didn't
he just say he likes horses?
Shot down in cold
blood.
Something
about circus horses.
The guy oozed confidence, like a regular French statesman.
Well, let's show him the paper.
The leading article referred to the visit of a Nobel Prize winner from some unpronounceable Eastern European state.
All right, we've seen everything. So we'll just tuck that away, make sure there's nothing else.
I considered straightening the table, but I figured it best not to disturb the evidence.
All right, let's go back over here to our manhole worker. We'll see if he wants to read our newspaper.
Hi, can you spare a few minutes?
What do you want now?
Would you like to read my newspaper?
I haven't got time to read that. Can't you see I'm busy?
You could read it on your lunch break.
10 minutes is all I get. And if my boss had his way, I wouldn't get that. He'd have me on a drip, so I didn't have to stop to eat.
Oh, take the newspaper and quit complaining.
Bah! Look at this. Damn bleeding heart liberals. Cha! Save the dolphins. Catch them and eat them, I say. All that fuss over a bunch of fish. Nah, that's more like it. Look at the size of those. Like champagne bottle corks, no? Ah, what's this? Salah ed-Din running in the Prix de l'Arc de Triomphe.
It's a racehorse?
A horse? A legend. Bucephalus reborn, mon ami. Like a streak of lightning she is.
Well?
Do me a favor, won't you? Keep an eye on my hole. I'm off to put some money on that nag.
What about your toolbox?
Stuff it. Help yourself.
That's funny. Keep an eye on my hole. Alright. Let's ransack this guy's
toolbox. I found just what I wanted. A tool for that big man.
Thank you. shall Narfle the Garthog.
I lifted the cover to reveal what smelt like the entrance to a sewer.
You think? Search the sewer. Maybe the clown dropped a clue. And we see a little red ball down here.
As I picked up the plastic ball, I realized it was intended to be worn.
Huh.
It was the clown's red nose.
Nice. Alright. Moving right along. And we found something else. What do we have here?
I scooped up the sodden tissue. It was cold and greasy, like breakfast leftovers.
We got one more piece of evidence here.
I took hold of the scrap of material and unsnagged it from the spike.
And while we're at it, hey, let's head up this ladder.
Hi there. Hold it right there, you sewer rat. I knew you'd come back. And now I've got you.
What are you talking about?
You're trespassing. Come out of there, immediately.
That's what I'm trying to do. Give me your hand.
Ha! You won't catch me with tricks like that. Keep your distance, monsieur.
Okay.
Now, what were you looking for?
Terrorists. The meanest, nastiest, dirtiest bunch of guys you ever saw.
Uh-huh. Englishmen, without a doubt. The filthy dogs. The day they opened that tunnel was a bad day for France. I tell you, if I still had the full use of my faculties, I'd march right over there and tell them so.
Well, whoever they are, they blew up the cafe.
What? The cafe? Blown up? Mon Dieu. That is awful.
The guy who did it was a calculating, cold-blooded killer. He was disguised as a clown. I followed him into the sewer, and I think he came this way.
Ah, mon Dieu! Then, the man I chased, do you think that man and the clown are one and the same?
Well, yes, it had crossed my mind.
Ah, that still does not explain what you were doing down the sewer. For all I know, you are in league with him.
Oh, no. I'm just a tourist.
Most tourists are content with the Eiffel Tower, the Louvre, or the Pigalle. I didn't realize my waste pipes were such an attraction.
All right, I think this is where we're going to call it, because we're running real short on time. I'll see you for part 7. Thank you.